The G2 from BAK Industries will be the company's middle of the road offering in regards to their hard tri-fold offerings and will be a fantastic choice for the 2015 and newer F-150 owners who are looking to add a ton of security to your bed cargo. Now the G2 here will be available in sizes to fit your 5.5 foot, 6.5 foot, and even 8 foot beds, and we'll start right around $875 for the 5.5 foot option we're talking about here today. Install will be a breeze as well, as we'll show you in a little bit, but expect a soft 1 out of 3 wrenches on the difficulty meter here and about an hour or less to complete from start to finish. But let's dive a little bit deeper into the G2, guys. And again, the middle of the road tri-fold from BAK Industries, existing just beneath the more premium MX4, also available on the site, and just above the more budget-friendly G1. Now, the big difference between the three options I just mentioned will come down to the materials of the actual panels here, guys. For instance, that more expensive MX4 will use durable aluminum exclusively for the panels, whereas the G2 here, on the other hand, is going to use what they call a solid panel, but with an aluminum skin, basically a composite material in the middle wrapped in aluminum. Now, that's still going to make for a very, very tough cover, and it's still going to deliver a ton of security, but the G2 here is going to deliver a weight rating of 300 pounds, versus the more expensive MX4, which will give you a 400 pound rating. So if that's important to you, that's the main difference. Now that aluminum has been given the gloss black powder coat, as you can see. It is also UV resistant, and that's gonna help prevent any fading on this thing over the years. Now, as far as the actual design is concerned, well, as the name implies, BAKFlip is going to be a flipping or folding cover. Trifold to be exact, as we've already said. And in my opinion, that is the most popular design that you are going to encounter in the category, at least here on our site. Now, there will be rolling options, such as the Revolver X2, also from BAK Industries. And there will also be a retractable hardcover option as well. But ultimately, I feel like the folding covers here will be the best way to go, or at least the most popular way to go when you're browsing for hardcovers on the site. Now, if you didn't know, the folding options I think are great because it's going to give you the option of flipping 1 or 2 sections up at a time. Or if you need to, you can flip the entire cover up and out of the way and gain full access to the entire bed. Now, the only drawback with this versus a rolling cover per se is that you do lose some visibility out of the rear window with this puppy folded all the way up. But as someone who has the same cover installed on my own F-150 between the side mirrors, in addition to the backup camera, it has really just been a non-issue. But one thing I do really enjoy about the BAKFlip cover here in general, besides its quality build, quality materials, things like that, is just how flush it sits with the bed rails once everything has been installed. And in my opinion, just makes for a much cleaner look. Now at the time of this video, guys, the BAKFlip, in addition to the undercover flex, will be your only two options on the site that's gonna deliver a very, very flush design. Retractable covers as well will do that, but if we're talking trifold, guys, this and the undercover are gonna be your two big options here. Options like X-Tang and WeatherTech do make a nice cover, but they are gonna stick up a little bit above the bed rails. Not a big deal to some truck owners out there, but for owners who prefer maybe that more flush, clean appearance, whatever you wanna call it, this is certainly gonna be a great choice. Now for you truck owners out there who might be a little unsure of how these things actually mount or install into your truck's bed, well, they're going to install using the included rails. They are aluminum, and those rails get clamped to your truck's bed rails using the included clamps. Very painless install and one that is totally reversible if you ever wanted to uninstall or maybe even transfer this over to your next truck. The cover does include a nice thick rubber seal on all four sides here and even in between those aluminum panels, guys. That's gonna help keep any water, rain, moisture out of the equation, keep your bed cargo nice and dry in the process. Now, as for your operation, well, these things really couldn't be much easier to use, guys. There's a little cable within the rails themselves that you're simply just gonna pull. That releases the latches, and at that point, you're just folding up and out of the way. It does include some straps if you wanted to secure the actual cover, maybe fold it up once or twice, but not totally up and out of the way. But if you wanted to fold it up and out of the way, it does include some struts to hold this thing in place while you're cruising on the highway. But let's touch a little bit more on that install, which again, will be very straightforward using some basic hand tools. And to give you a better idea of how it's all gonna go down, here is that detailed walkthrough we promised you, along with a quick tool breakdown.
Tools required for this installation: Phillips head screwdriver, flathead screwdriver, 3/8 inch drive, 14 millimeter socket. All right, so your first step is you're gonna wanna install your bed rails on the inside of the bed. And if you don't have a drop-in bed liner or bed rails like this has, they do supply you with some double-sided grommet to put on there to raise it up just a little bit. So we're gonna set it on the bed rail just like this. You're gonna use three clamps per side. We're kind of going loose on these for right now, because if there's any adjustments we want to make, we'll be able to do so with it loosely put on there. And once we're done tightening up this, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. All right, so your next step is you're gonna wanna take your tonneau cover with the straps facing towards the front and set it into place. Now it should pretty much just slip right in between the rails on both sides. And then we'll worry about positioning it when we get to our next step. Okay, so your next step is you're gonna wanna take the buckle end and with the supplied hardware, put the collars on the back side like that. And then on the front, line it up and start your Phillips head screws through it. And this is gonna be the same on the other side. All right, so one of the big problems with the tonneau cover is when it's in the upward position, in the stowed position, this is gonna hit your back glass. Now, BAK Industries is gonna hook you up with three rubber bumpers that you put on this metal strip right here. And you wanna evenly space them out and make sure you have a clean surface to mount these to. Take off the tape. Here in the middle. So now, you gotta put your top up. Just hits against that rubber. All right, so your next step is you're gonna take your bolt here that BAK Industry supplied you with, and you're gonna take it almost completely apart. And this is gonna be on the back side, underneath it. So you're gonna take your lock washer off, your flat washer. You're gonna leave one rubber washer in that collar, and under here, you'll see that rail that we're gonna mount to. It's gonna go through like that. And then I'm gonna go underneath and tighten it down. All right, so now that we're underneath the tonneau cover, again, it's gonna be rubber washer, flat washer, lock washer. And you're just gonna snug that up. And you're gonna repeat that on the other side as well. All right, so your next step is to make sure that your tonneau cover is even on both sides and folds down very nicely. Now at the end, close your tailgate and close your top. All right, so now that you like the way that your tonneau cover is fitting, we're going to be putting the tonneau cover back up in the resting position. And we're going to be tightening the six clamps we put on earlier. All right, this is the drain tube for the tonneau cover. Now we're on the front side of the tonneau cover and this is the drain hole. We are going to put our hose right up into there. Now some boxes have a grommet on the side here, on the front here, or down here. Our truck only has one, so we are going to be running our tube down into that. Now you can drill a hole and make it look clean. We're not going to be doing that. We are just going to be popping out this grommet here. Running it through just like that. All right, same thing on the other side. All right, that's gonna wrap up my install of the BAK Industries BAKFlip G2 tonneau cover. For all things F-150, keep it here at AmericanTrucks.com.